Okay, how does Indiana respond tomorrow night?
Well, easy as it sounds, you have to forget about that shot. Because a shot like that, it'll kill you all night. You'll be like, shouldn't let him caught the ball. We should have did this, should have did that. The goaltender didn't call it. Forget about all that. You know what you got to do. You probably had a great practice today. Believe that you can win. You play well at home. And just, you know, step up to the challenge. Because it's, you know, it's one of those games. You know, like when you're on the road and you're playing one of the best players and you got them and, you know, you almost, you know, win the game and then, you know, he hits the last shot. It could actually take all the air out of you. But you have to say to yourself, you know what? And I was actually looking at the guys' eyes. I believe that they believe that they can, you know, still be in the series. But, again, you just have to forget about that shot.
That's always a question that you guys always get asked. Would you rather get beat by 25 and just try to flush that one and come back? Or do you want to
I never worry about that because a loss is a loss.
Like
but
that.
As you see in this Celtic-Milwaukee series, think about it. Every game's his own thing, man. Like, Boston won the first two. Milwaukee win the next year. Like, they got Boston on the ropes. They go to Boston, and they go back home. They win. Milwaukee's on the ropes. They go home, and they win. So you just have to play well. You know, Oladipo, Hal just told me, he's 12 for 50 the last few games.
Yeah, J.R. Smith been making life difficult on him, too.
Yeah, but he's got to play well.
Yeah.
And listen, when you play at home, you got to get off to a good start to get the crowd in the game because you can't play from behind. Because you play from behind, those shots start shrinking down the stretch. You're like, uh-oh, we need to make a shot or we're going to lose. So the most important thing is to get off to a good start and get the crowd in the game.
That was kind of like Utah last night when Oklahoma City came back at him, and it looked like the basket got about that big for Utah. Nothing was falling as Oklahoma City made that run. Now, go ahead. You rather lose by 25 or lose at the horn?
I'd rather lose at the buzzer because I know I'm in the game. I think sometimes when you lose by 20 or more, you just think the other team is just better than you, that you don't really have answers for them. And when you lose by one, your confidence, to me, my confidence was always, oh, there's only a play or two here because this worked all night. This yeah. worked all night, and we just have to get into that more. So for me, you know, I lose by the buzzer, and you got to jump. I said, it takes a shot like that. This is how I would think. It takes a shot like that, and you got to jump on the stanchion to beat me, you know? I'm not thinking that you're laughing on the side and doing bottle flips like LeBron has done when they're up 20. So, no, you got to jump on the stanchion when you beat me. You know
or the
what?
Scorers table.
And I forgot to mention one thing. They know the scorers
table.
One thing about the Pacers, they can know when they go. I bet when they went and looked at that tape, like, man, Sabonis and Thaddeus Young got a layup every single time in the post. And that's something you're like, oh, every time we run these particular plays, they have a mismatch on the other end, down in the paint. And Oladipo's not going to go 12 for 50 like he had the last two or three games. But they know every time Thaddeus Young, Sabonis just mauling them little fellas down low.